Good afternoon, everybody. Today I am discussing the basics of the GRD. GRD is also called as gastroesophageal reflux disease. It is caused due to the reflux of the acid into the esophagus or food pipe due to the weakness of the lower esophageal junction. It is a most common symptoms that can be seen in a day-to-day practice in a day-to-day patients. There are so many causes of the GRD. The most important cause, why it is occur? As I have already told, it is occur due to the reflux of the acid into the esophagus. There is a called as lower esophageal sphincter. Normally what the sphincter do? It prevents the reflux of the acid into the esophagus in a particularly patient who present with that symptoms. There is a weakness of that lower esophageal sphincter. Due to that, acid gets into the esophagus from the stomach and which causes irritation of the esophageal lining. There are different types of the due to that irritation esophagus, there is a formation of the ulcers which have different grades, like esophagitis, which is called as esophagitis. There are four grades of the esophagitis: esophagitis A, esophagitis B, esophagitis C, and esophagitis D. Mostly what patient came with the following symptoms who is having GRD. The most common symptom the patient came with: burning sensation in the retrosternal area or chest, in the chest. Some patient may present with the chest pain or burning sensation in the upper abdomen. There is also patient came with difficulty in swallowing, regurgitation of the fluid and sore liquid. Some patient came with the sensation of the lump in the throat. GRD can be present in certain cases with a chronic cough, laryngitis. Some patient may present with the asthma and disturbed sleep also. What are the risk factors for the GRD? There are certain risk factors for the GRD, such as obesity, pregnancy, some connective tissue disorders like scleroderma, or delayed emptying time. Particularly in diabetes, there is a delayed emptying time which causes GRD. There are certain modifiable factors like smoking, certain foods may trigger the GRD, taking tea, coffee, alcohol beverages and peppermint tablets, which can precipitate GRD. What are the complications of GRD? The complications can present with the narrowing of esophagus, which is called as esophageal stricture. Some patient presents with the esophageal ulcer and may be present as a Barrett esophagus, which is a premalignant condition. So how we can prevent the GRD and how we can diagnose the GRD? There are certain tests by which we can diagnose the GRD. The most important test is endoscopy, upper GI endoscopy or gastroscopy, in which we also diagnose GRD and the severity of the GRD, like esophagitis. What are the treatments of the GRD? Medical treatment and lifestyle modification, these are the main treatment of the GRD. Lifestyle modification in the form of weight loss, particularly in the obese patient, and frequent intake of the small meals instead of taking large meal single time. And patient is advised not to sleep 2 hours or immediately after the meal. Patient is also counseled regarding the stop smoking, stop alcohol consumption, and medical line of treatment in the form of proton pump inhibitor and prokinetics, which decreases the acid and which also increases the lower esophageal sphincter tone. So we can prevent, we can treat, and we can diagnose the GRD. Thank you.